Drink Wine, my name is Cece Mansur. I'll be your physical therapist today. Thank you for coming. We're going to start off with some questions and then move into tests and measures. And the question part should only take around 15 minutes. So you ready to get started?
Yeah.
Okay, so throughout the interview, I'm just going to be taking some notes. Is that all right with you?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so I wanted to start off by verifying some information. How old are you?
24.
Okay, what do you do for a living?
So I'm actually a dancer at SeaWorld. I have a chipmunk costume that I actually dance in. And for about, 40 hours a week, I am up on stage for performances and, concerts and all that kind of stuff.
Okay, so your job's very active?
Very active.
Okay, so what do you like to do for exercise?
Pretty much once I'm done with work, I'm just so tired that I can't do anything else but, go home and relax. So, honestly, dancing being my full job, that's my exercise, so.
Okay. And what hobbies do you have?
So I love to go to happy hour with my friends, my work friends, right after work. And, we spend time together, drink a little, kind of loosen up. It's pretty fun.
Okay. Yeah, I like to go out with my friends too. So what's your living situation like?
Live by myself with my dog at my house. It's one story and like no stairs. Like it's a pretty flat place. So, walking around on my crutches, it's pretty easy.
Okay. So you use crutches.
Mm-hmm.
How long have you been using them?
4 weeks since my injury.
Okay, and were you taught how to use crutches?
Kind of. They were handed to me, and I was told I was going to be using them, and I think I'm okay with them. Like it's pretty easy walking around on them, so I don't really think I have problems with it.
Okay, so I'll just have you demonstrate how you walk with the crutches later on.
Okay.
Is that all right?
Yeah.
Okay, so what brings you into physical therapy today?
So, 4 weeks ago, I was, hanging these flower things outside my house, and they're kind of high up, so I was standing on this, large pot thing, and I started to lose my balance, and as I was falling, my dog was, running around under me, and so, trying to avoid him, I stepped around him, and it was really awkward when my heel hit the ground, and I just felt this, big strain just in my left thigh. It was bad.
Okay. So where is your pain located?
So left thigh, and it goes, right about to where my knee starts to right about, right at the end of my back thigh.
Okay. So I drew where your pain is located. Does that look about accurate to you?
Yeah, that looks good. That's perfect.
Okay. So how would you describe your pain?
So it's pretty achy. When it happened, it was sharp and just like a real pull. But, sitting here is kind of just achy and annoying.
Okay. And how high does your pain go? So it starts here. Does it go any higher?
No, just right there.
And how low does it go?
Just to my left knee. Just kind of stops right where that starts.
Okay. And so on a scale of 0 to 10, 0 being no pain, 10 being the worst pain you've ever had, what is your pain right now?
That's about a 1.
Okay. And what about at its worst?
Just a 6.
Okay.
It's not horrible, but it's not great.
Okay. And what about at its best?
A 0, actually.
Oh, good, good, good. That's good to hear. And so, just to be clear, you don't have any pain in the front of your legs?
No.
Your left nor your right?
Mm-mm.
Okay. And what about down on your shin?
Nope.
And your right leg either?
Nope.
Okay. And your feet? Either of your feet?
Nothing.
Okay. And your stomach?
Mm-mm.
Your chest?
Mm-mm.
Your left arm?
Nope.
Your right arm? In your neck?
Nothing there.
Your back?
Mm-mm.
In your head?
Nope.
Okay, good. Okay, so what makes your pain worse?
So if I'm walking, you know, like more than 2 minutes, I start to, you know, feel that pull and that strain and, you know, kind of sharp pain in the back of my left thigh.
Okay, so just to be clear, after you've been walking for 2 minutes, the pain starts to come on.
Yeah.
Okay. And anything else that aggravates it?
Nope, just that. Okay. Oh, actually, you know what? I've tried to do some, like, dancing moves to just try to keep it, like, my muscle memory. But, you know, I can't do that for more than 2 minutes. And if I'm up on my toes, it's just game over, so.
Okay. All right. And so what makes it feel better?
You know, when I'm back at home and I am lying down and resting and I can ice my thigh and just take my medication for it, I feel better.
Okay, and how long before it starts to go away after you take the medication and rest?
I'd say overall, like 5 to 10 minutes. It starts to, like, ease back.
Okay, good. So how does your leg feel in the morning?
It's pretty stiff. Actually, that stiffness kind of stays with me, you know, throughout the day. I mean, I'm on crutches, so, you know, I can't dance and, you know, stretch out my limbs and, you know, exercise them. So, like, I stay pretty stiff. So, morning, definitely stiff.
Okay. And how does your leg feel during the day?
Also pretty stiff, but it's okay. I mean, it's not crazy painful, but, you know, stiff and just dull, achy kind of pain.
Okay. And how does your leg feel at night?
A little bit better when I start to, you know, rest it and ice it and use my medication. But there's still a little bit of stiffness because I haven't really tried to, you know, exercise it out.
Okay. And what about throughout the night?
Actually, it's okay. You know, if I'm not moving a lot when I sleep, then totally fine.
Okay, good. And so thank you for filling out the intake form, the form you filled out before we started talking. I just want to review it, go over a couple of things just to confirm. Okay. So I see here that you take Mobic.
Mm-hmm.
Is that the only medication you take?
That's it.
Okay. And you learn best by doing?
Mm-hmm. Absolutely.
Okay. So what do you mean by that?
So, definitely with dancing, I've learned I'm really good with, like, muscle memory and muscle movement and all that.
Okay.
So, like, my whole day is about doing and moving. So, okay. Yeah.
Okay, perfect. Yeah, there will be a lot of that during mm-hmm. physical therapy. And so you don't use tobacco?
Nope.
Okay. And I see here that you have alcohol consumption down for 4 drinks per week.
Yep.
Is that about accurate?
That's accurate.
Okay. And then yourself and your family medical history, no cancer, diabetes, high blood pressure,
mm-mm.
heart disease, stroke,
nope.
rheumatoid arthritis?
Mm-mm.
Okay, perfect. And then I see that you have filled out yes for the neurological disease, anxiety.
Mm-hmm.
How do you manage that?
So, you know, my anxiety is kind of hard to manage, but when I'm really active and when I'm moving, my anxiety levels go down.
Mm-hmm.
And so, yeah, that's pretty much the only way I manage it. But because I haven't been dancing for so long, you know, my anxiety is just through the roof. So.
Okay. Well, I'm sorry to hear that. I know that dancing seems like it's very important to you. So if it's important to you, it's important to me. We're going to make that our top goal, okay?
Great.
So we can get you back to dancing as soon as possible. And then, so you also filled out that you've had prior surgery?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so when I was 18, I actually was cheerleading, and I felt really weird, and I saw my doctor, and he had me do surgery for what he said was a right hip labral strain.
Okay.
Yeah.
And how'd the surgery go?
It went well. Any residual, you know, lingering kind of feelings that I have, like, they're totally manageable. So
okay.
I don't worry about it.
Good. And then you also circled yes for trauma?
Yeah, you know, I circled that because of the way I fell. I didn't really totally know how to answer it, but the way I fell was pretty traumatizing. So, okay. Yeah.
Okay. And then you also put down here that you have sustained morning stiffness. Mm.
Yeah. So, again, just because I'm not dancing and I'm not moving and all that, like, I don't ever get to stretch out. And I don't get to, you know, move my left leg at all. So, just, I'm very stiff in the morning. Yeah.
Okay. And so now I'll just ask you three more questions. Have you had imaging on your leg?
Yes. I had an x-ray and an MRI.
Okay.
Yeah.
And what were the results of the x-ray and MRI?
It led to my doctor telling me I had a left hamstring strain.
Okay. And just to confirm, the only medication you take is Mobic, mm-hmm. correct?
That's it.
Okay. And have you injured this area before?
No.
And so what do you want to get out of physical therapy?
Well, I definitely really want to go back to dancing. So, you know, just
right.
getting back to, you know, like where I was, you know, before my injury. And I really want to be mobile. So any kind of movements I do for dance and just being around the house, I really want to, you know, get back to that.
Okay, good. Yes, like I had mentioned earlier, that'll be our top goal. But I also have another goal for you, so I want you to be able to walk for longer than 2 minutes without any pain.
Yeah.
So just to let you know, that's another goal of mine. And so, do you have any questions or concerns for me?
Yeah, you know, I had this friend who did physical therapy, and she just had the worst experience. Like, she was in so much pain, and she thinks her physical therapist, you know, caused her pain. And I just don't want that to happen to me, you know. I'm just, like, afraid, like, that, you know, you could hurt me, that physical therapy could hurt me, and I just don't know if this is a good fit. So.
Okay. Well, I'm sorry that your friend had that experience, but I assure you that your experience here will be a good one, and feel free at any time that you are feeling any type of pain to let me know, because I can alter my treatment to help you and make you feel better, because that's what I'm here for, is for you and to get you back to what you were doing before.
Okay,
sounds good.
Yeah.
Okay, so now we'll get into the test and measures part of the exam. Okay.